जब कई कहानियां मिलती हैं तो गाथाएं लिखी जाती हैं। एक गाथा लिखने में सालों लग जाते हैं, एक गाथा सैकड़ों लोगों की कहानियां होती हैं। कुछ ऐसी है हमारी गाथा, जन बैंक की गाथा। ये सैकड़ों नहीं, हजारों नहीं, बल्कि लाखों लोगों की कहानियों से मिलकर बनी है। इस गाथा के लिखने की शुरुआत हुई थी एक प्रसिद्ध एनजीओ मायराडा के साथ 1999 में, एक छोटे से कमरे में, एक छोटी सी कहानी के साथ।
I was fascinated by their work. I had gone and, you know, gone to the villages, seen how they did their work and so on. And Ashutosh Fernandez was the executive director. And I said, is there anything I can do, anything I can be a part of? And he said, we're starting this thing, Sangamitra. Can you help us, given your banking background, can you come on the board and help us to run it maybe better and so on? And I agreed. I said, yeah, I'll be happy to do that, but with one condition. While I respect the work that you guys do, which is in rural development and so on, for my wife and me, our heart is in urban issues. I don't have an institution. Will you allow me to set up an experiment, a program for urban poor, working on the same microfinance, group loans and things like that? If it works out, great. We'll see what to do with it. If it doesn't, it's an experiment. And he immediately agreed. So in 99, I joined the board of Sangamitra. And we started an initiative in 2000 called the Sangamitra Urban Program.
Year 2000 में Sangamitra Urban Program ने पहला group loan दिया था, जो कि शायद इस देश के urban microfinance इतिहास का पहला loan था, पहला किस्सा। और इसके बाद सैकड़ों, हजारों किस्से जुड़ते चले गए। सिर्फ 18 महीनों में वो एक कहानी हजारों कहानियां बन चुकी थी।
I was looking for an opportunity to do something different. Somewhere where I could use my professional skills in a different way, which would also make meaning in somebody's life.
We were just one among the five, two people in the field, three in the office, like one Cecil Lazarus, he was head operation, and one more lady as admin manager, and I am the assisting everything.
It is a startup. I mean, the same sort of feeling that any startup today will have, the excitement. Only difference being that I was 62 years old at that time.
I think at certain stages in one's life, you sort of say, why should I do the same old routine thing?
When I went and met many of the stalwarts, the big fear was that ye nahi hoga, urban mein nahi hoga, kyunki wo rural mein they know each other, wo social capital jo hai, jo jaane pehchane hai, wo hai nahi. Ye railway platform pe rehte hain, inko kaise jaan sakte hain ek dusre ko? But one of the things I learned as we went and met these the poor was that they have been living in that same area for 15, 20, sometimes more than one generation. So they knew each other well. And their need was still, you know, massive and substantial. So for the first 5 years, all we were doing was basically learning, trying to replicate what was already happening both in India and in other countries on rural microfinance, but in the urban setting. I remember it took us 16 months to do the first crore, to reach 1 crore of lending. 16 months it took us. In March this year, we did 1,750 crores in 1 month.
2006 में हमारे urban finance program की कहानी में एक बड़ा मोड़ आया। हमारी कहानी बड़ी होने लगी थी। हमारी कहानी अब जनलक्ष्मी की कहानी बन गई।
What they wanted from financial services standpoint was not just a loan. They don't want a group loan. They're saying, हाँ ले लेंगे, अगर ग्रुप लोन देंगे तो ले लेंगे, लेकिन इससे और भी चाहिए हमें। जिस विलेज से मैं आया था वहाँ पैसा भेजना है, आई वॉन्ट टू रेमिट मनी, आई हैव एक्स्ट्रा मनी, इट्स नॉट लाइक आई डोंट हैव मनी, बट आई डोंट हैव एनी वे टू सेव। आई वॉन्ट टू प्लेस वर आई कैन सेव माई मनी सेफली, आई वॉन्ट टू प्लेस दैट आई कैन थिंक अबाउट माई चिल्ड्रंस एजुकेशन, आई वॉन्ट टू प्लेस टू थिंक अबाउट माई रिटायरमेंट प्लानिंग एंड माई पेंशन प्रोग्राम। सो एक्चुअली वॉट दे वॉन्टेड वॉज अ बैंक। एंड सो द पेनी ड्रॉप्ड फॉर अस इन 2006 After 5 years and 6 years of doing this, to say what we need to build is a bank for the poor.
कुछ ऐसी ही सोच से 2008 में NBFC बन गया। जनलक्ष्मी को मिला NBFC लाइसेंस और जनलक्ष्मी बन गई जनलक्ष्मी फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज। और बैंगलोर के बाहर खुला पहला जन सेंटर कोयम्बतूर में। इट क्रॉस्ड 1 लाख कस्टमर्स इन 2009, जो सब हमारी कहानी के साथ जुड़ गए। पर हर कहानी की तरह हमारी कहानी में भी कई उतार चढ़ाव आए, कई अड़चनें।
Toughest stretch, right? Between 2007 and 2010.
Correct.
Those years were brutal.
Yeah.
Everything that could go wrong, going wrong. In this business, if you don't have money yourself, you can't lend money to other people. And there would be days together where, you know, bankers won't lend to us. They won't give us the money. And that's when both Chinu and Radha put in the money, gave the message to the troops.
I could not help this company technologically because I didn't know anything about technology. I had some money, my wife had some money, give it to them. Also very important is who were the people who started this company. We're not a unit any old fellow. The fellow that it was Ramesh and Swati, we had confidence in them. I mean, it's a mutual. And you can't compare to other companies because it's something which comes from the gut.
If you felt instinctively very comfortable with the people you worked with, and that comes, as Chino says, from the heart, I think that's what makes the difference. That's what enables you to put your money where your mouth is. And at the end of the day, if we actually put in money, imagine the message that it gives to the bankers. Listen, we don't have a stake. Ramesh doesn't have a stake in the company. He doesn't take any financial benefit. He's putting in money. Chinu is putting in money. I'm putting in money in a small way. Just indicates the faith that we have. Just have faith in us.
And the first bank that actually gave the big support, I think, was Union Bank.
Union Bank. That's what I
was saying. One time in my life when I felt on real tenterhooks. And he came and told us, I think this will be approved. Boy. Even then, not formally, but this guy said it. And after 1 week, he heard about it. That was a relief.
2011 में जनलक्ष्मी फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज पूरे देश में पहली संस्था बन गई. हमारी कहानी एक कमरे, एक ऑफिस, एक शहर से बढ़कर पूरे देश की कहानियों से जुड़ गई. 2011 में कस्टमर्स 1 लाख से बढ़कर 2 लाख हो गए थे. सपने बड़े हो रहे थे, कहानियां बड़ी हो रही थी. और लाखों कहानियों का कल लिखने के लिए जरूरी था खुद के कल से आगे निकल जाना.
We had very high investments in technology and like we, some people kept saying you're building a Rolls Royce from when you need a Maruti.
So we wanted people to believe that they're coming in to do banking. So they wanted a good building, we wanted them to be treated well, we wanted to have a cashier counter, good chairs for the customers. All of that mattered to us. So from day one, we wanted to do more than one, just lending. So savings was important to us, pensions was important to us. So that was very different compared to every other MFI that was there. The power of what Janalakshmi is, and even when it began, was that it's always been a shared vision. From the time Chinu came in late 2005 and actually built out the first steps of making us an institution, it's been a shared vision. And then subsequently Radha came in 2007. Many people in senior management have come and joined us.
I came from an investment banking background and a commercial banking background, you know, where sensitivity and feelings don't exist. But then when I saw this and I said, my God, there's something that he's already done Janagra. I've seen something in Janagra. There's something quite different.
I think the reality is we knew the market segment the institution was serving is different. The structure was very different. And the commitment of the promoters, frankly, to be honest, the team below was very unique. So I think sometimes, you know, you just need that confluence of multiple factors. It sort of makes the institution different. It sort of appeals to your emotion. That's what I don't think I would have done it if it had been a regular banking institution, to be honest.
जो अपनी कहानी औरों की कहानियां पूरी करके लिखते हैं, उनकी कहानी एक गाथा बन जाती है. 2014 में ऐसा ही कुछ हुआ जब जनलक्ष्मी फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज देश की सबसे बड़ी अर्बन माइक्रो फाइनेंस संस्था बन गई. 2011 के 66 जनसेंटर्स 2016 में 332 जनसेंटर्स बन गए. 2013 में 7 लाख कस्टमर्स 2016 में 46 लाख कस्टमर्स बन गए. संगमित्रा अर्बन प्रोग्राम से लेकर जन बैंक तक की कहानियों का सफर एक गाथा है, एक महाकाव्य जिसमें कहानियां जुड़ती गईं, सैकड़ों, हजारों, लाखों कहानियां. रमेश रामनाथन की कहानी, आर श्रीनिवासन की कहानी, राधा कृष्णन की कहानी, हमारे हजारों जननायकों की कहानियां, हमारे लाखों कस्टमर्स की कहानियां. ये सिर्फ एक बैंक नहीं, लाखों कहानियों का बैंक है जिसमें और लाखों करोड़ों कहानियां जुड़ने वाली हैं. एक छोटी सी कहानी, एक छोटी सी शुरुआत बैंकिंग इंडस्ट्री की महागाथा बनने वाली है, क्योंकि अब जन बैंक खुल गया है.